So, welcome back to this very last episode, our epilogue of our Prussian Let's Play. Let's turn on the music again. Like so, perhaps? Yeah, so that was the Kaiserliche Armee song. Oh, I forgot what it's actually called. A very well-known Prussian melody. War March, I'm not really sure. But yeah, this is the epilogue. So let's start by looking at, let's say, the ledger. Oh, well, let's just let the game run for one tick so things update. Nothing bad will happen. Nope. Okay, good. So let's see how we did. Income? Oh, we have the most income. I was not expecting that. Haven't really checked it before. We have the most development. This is our own. This is not counting our underlings. You can see Prussian Texas down here. Austria is also ours. Kingdom of Italy is ours. Yeah, not too bad. We have all the tech, all the ideas. 43 power projection, but we haven't really been grabbing anything for a while. Governments, okay, not interesting. Score comparison. We did okay. Oh damn, Mamluks did very well. Hmm. Interesting. Score through the ages. We got a very small amount in discovery. A certain amount in reformation. A good amount in absolutism. The very good amount in revolutions. That's nice. Religion. Yeah, Protestant's doing okay. Nothing amazing. Province development? Nah. Advisors? Nah. Military leaders? Yeah, we were blessed with very good generals throughout most of the game. Ferdinand von Rausch here. Almost 6 in everything. I don't think I've ever seen a 6-6-6-6 general. But 23 also, well, the two others here at the top three are also quite very, quite nice. Previous rulers, we kept the von Hohenzollern throughout the entire game. This is actually before the game started, von Luxemburg here. I think this is a regency, von Schreibrücken. Yeah, it must have been. Yeah, von Hohenzollern kept the throne. And we were blessed with some pretty good leaders. Let's see. 12, that's 14. That's 14. 16 here, Johann Sigmund. That's pretty good. I think that might be the best one we got. 16. That's 13. That's 14. 14. 13. Yeah. But we have been blessed with some very, very good leaders. Several of them. Yeah, Johann Sigmund. I think you were the best. Got you rather early. That's nice. Quality. You have the most morale. Most discipline. Most siege ability. Not the most defensiveness. Professionalism, 100%. Tradition, 100%. So, yeah. Our army size ain't that great. It's okay, but we are more quality over quantity here. Navy, well, it's a thing. Army losses, we lost 3.8 million, almost 3.7 million. More to attrition than usual. I was a bit careless at times with attrition. But yeah. Naval losses, I think we lost a decent chunk. 72 ships. Nothing too crazy. Income. Taxes? Yeah. Production? Yeah. Trade? No. Oh, we never moved it, our trade to Lübeck, I think. No. Forgot about that. Tariffs? Oh, something. Vassals? A decent amount. Well, the most in the entire game. By a long shot. But in total, we are making the most buck, just eclipsing Great Britain. No interesting charts, everything is Protestant, everything is cored. Good amount of Prussians. Making a lot of cloth, grain, livestock, salt. English Channel being the biggest node. Market share, we didn't really do great trading game here, but we have some we are controlling here, so that's nice. Trade, well, Great Britain ruling there for sure. Oh, Batavia doing very well. And coalitions, yeah, against us, goes to Spelai, yep. Oh, no current wars at all, damn. But we are the first in great power rating. That's nice. Right, should we look at a timeline? Sure. All right, so that was the timeline. I must say it's one of the more prettier European maps I've made throughout the time I've been, well, putting out YouTube videos / U4 videos. Of course, I would have liked to have gained more stuff for the Ottomans, given this stuff here to Russia. Let the Scandinavia formed, and clean up this bits here in France. I think that would have been perfect in terms of Europe and, well, parts of the Middle East here. And we also got our own little Prussian Texas, who ain't that small. I've been feeding them quite a lot here. They have 965 development, so ain't too bad. Right, let's look at the map, of course, some map modes. The Imperial Holy Roman Empire is gone. Religion-wise, we are converting everything under us to Protestant, so that's fine. Oh, you're not Protestant? Prussia? Oh, you're not. Oh. Well, become Prussian. Yeah, there we go. Protestant, become Prussian. I wish. But Catholic, South America, still some entities around. Yeah, the AI never really seems to cult convert / convert. Not that much, it seems. Which is a bit annoying. This should, to be honest. Everything okay. Tengri, confusion. A lot of Buddhism here. Yeah. Mongolia did a number of on China here, so they took up the mantle of being the emperor. Not doing too great right now. But yeah. Culture-wise, well, we did culture convert a bit here in the east, eastern parts of Germany, to Prussian, and parts of Poland. And the Austrians are actually also culture converting. So, the AI used... Okay, I guess the Czech... Or is that... Oh, that must... Maybe... that must be... Austria converting this stuff here, right? Since they probably accepted Czech, but not Hungarian. No, they also accept Hungarian. Okay, that's odd. Alright, so you'd really like to culture convert here, Austria. Interesting. Not really sure if anything is out of order. Bit of a mixed bag over here. Mexican, Dutch, American, English, North, South America, Brazilian, South America. I think just for the lols, that will form Germany, just to see their mission tree here. Oh right, I never got this fixed. Oh well. Just for the lols. Germany. Now that looks a lot more like World War One borders. Blood and Iron. I'm not gonna read it, but we'll do a proper German Let's Play, Germany Let's Play later. Where we try to blob as much as we can. Like, take over all of Europe as Germany. As they usually want to do. Okay, damn. Okay. Blood and Iron. So they get claims on all of that? Jesus Christ. Okay. That's crazy. Italian invasion. 3 in diplomatic power. Whew. Let's just boost, use our points just to say our development is higher. Sure. Oh, we can't get. Oh, we need France before we can do this. Okay. And we need to own it directly? Promote. Burgers. Equilibrium goes up. Okay, sure. The Rhineland. Goods produced in these areas. Oh, damn. Okay. And we need more trade power. Okay. I see. Imperial Navy. Sure. Establish the chancellorship. Plus one. At we get a level 3 statesman. 90% cheaper. Holy Christ. Okay. Control the Junkers. Sure. Compulsory education. Culture convert down. Institution spread. Okay. think that's it what we could do right now. Carpathian conquest. We need to own it directly, or they need to have less. Yeah. Yeah. Basically, you need. Okay, you get claims on a lot of stuff here. Dominate Europe. Scramble for Africa. Crush the revolution. Nice. Alright, well. No, wait, let's look at the development map move as well. Oh, look at that Germany. Very yellow. Can we make it even a slightly more yellow? Greenish. Oh, ran out of admin points. Okay. There we go. So, looking very well developed here, that much is certain. Europe usually is. 49 development there. Oh damn, 50 over in Chickasaw. Sweet. Yep, so, it's over. And I'm going to try the Abinar Total Conversion mod here. And if it's fun, I'll probably do a couple of Let's Plays with it, and then maybe stop playing it a bit, go back to normal EU4 again, and maybe have it as a, well, something in the backhand, if that's something you can say, to play every once in a while, to change things up. I am looking forward to trying Abinar. I haven't tried it yet. I want to finish these Let's Plays first. I've been watching a few YouTubers play it, a Roomba, a Lambert, and also one of my channel members, Tim Marino, as well. He has his own little YouTube channel, and he's growing at a decent pace, so go check him out if you want to. You can see his name in the description. I don't think I have a link for it, but I guess you can just type in the name. Right, anyways, thanks for watching, and I hope I see you all next time. Bye. Oh, right, before I end, a big extra thanks to my channel members, of course. David Wilson, Mike Murray, Tim Marino, and Christoph Kroll, and Wiscomat. Thanks a lot, guys. Bye.